Hello and welcome to Summer Camp on the Commodore 64. Well, this was an original game, it's a Thalamus game, but it's not really what you'd expect. I've seen it in a Thalamus game back then. Probably more famous for sort of shoot-em-ups. I think Queen chose it just came out before this, so they were switching their games to be a little more varied in terms of the genre that they normally put out. So right away, you can see this is a cutesy platformer, and I do like the graphic style. I mean, they're quite well done, I think, very cartoony. The music's okay, it gets a bit annoying fairly quickly. But it is a flick screen platformer, and this is 1990 this came out, so it felt pretty old fashioned even when it came out. Sonic had already been out, and games like Turrican had already come out, I think. A flick screen platformer game feel a bit old fashioned by this time. So there's sort of mini puzzles, using these cue balls. You can jump on balloons and things. And the action is fairly, it is fairly pixel perfect. And this is where the game falls down a little bit, I think, because the controls feel a little imprecise. A little sloppy controls. Definitely my biggest bugbear with the game is the controls. So the aim of the game is to find a piece of blueprint. You can see the top right of the screen there's a blueprint I've got a lot about it. Pick up these Acme crates, Acme boxes, they contain bits of blueprint, if I remember. Yep, there you go. Once you've got enough blueprint, you can go into the next level. I think there's four levels, including one on the moon or Mars or something. It's just high sort of bouncy levels, bouncy floors. Nice humorous touches. In the game, you've picked up a parachute, but it opens after you've landed. A nice little humorous touch. There's nothing that's going to have you clutching your sides with laughter. It's a fairly gentle humor. Again, pixel perfect jumping. That was a bit unfair. You enter a screen and you die right away. Now, these little presentation screens are quite well done. And you can type your name in as well, that's nice. Yeah. So yeah, that's Summer Camp for you. It's an okay platform game. I mean, it's nothing brilliant. Playable, but if you get frustrated by some pixel perfect jumping and things, you won't like this game at all. Just trying to deploy the parachute. It was also had a follow-up game called Winter Camp, which had a bit more variety in terms of the gameplay. I'm not a huge fan of that game either, to be honest. And despite its neat touches, it doesn't look quite polished, you'd expect of a Thalamus game back then, but Having said that, I mean, the gameplay is... It's got more solid gameplay than some of the Thalamus games, to be fair. Is that music getting annoying yet? So, yep, that's Summer Camp for you. It's an okay platformer, but yeah, it's not special. Sound effects, music are okay, but get annoying pretty fast. Graphics are nice. Quite well done. But yeah, gameplay does let in a little bit. So, I'll give this. Give a 6 out of 10, I think it's average, fairly average game. Nothing special, but you know, nothing shockingly bad. Yeah, if you like these sort of platform games, worth a look. See you in the next video.